Welcome to a new Precious Plastic video. In the previous video, we learned all about plastic, we built our own machines and we collected the material. And now it's time to create new things. So first we're going to talk a little bit about different melting temperatures of the plastic. Then we're going to talk about mold making, how to make your own molds and where to look out for. And then we're going to create objects from plastic waste. Let's go! So when you heat up plastic, it melts, but every type of plastic melts at a different temperature. Now you can easily look up the melting temperature online, but this is just a number and it doesn't really say much. We wanted to make it more visual for you guys. So we did a lot of different melting temperature experiments and made research. So each row is a different type of plastic, and here it's 120 degrees and here it's 280. And as you can see, some plastics start to melt at lower temperature, while others need much higher temperature to melt. And also some materials have a very long melting zone, where others are quite crucial, and you need to have the temperature quite accurate in order to have it melt properly, otherwise it burns. Yep. And this is a useful reference when you start working with plastic to see what it does at what temperature.
So for instance, we can see what polystyrene does at 200 degrees.
And we turned this in a poster, which you can download and print to put in your workspace, or just watch it digitally. Overall, the principle of working with plastic is that you heat it up, you mold it, and then you let it cool down. You can shape plastic in almost any form when it's molten. However, for production, it's better to work with a mold because you can easily replicate. So metal is a good material because the plastic doesn't stick to it, and if it does, you can scrape it off. Next to that is durable and it can withstand the heat. Now our machines work with a whole variety of molds. You can CNC them, you can weld or make them on the lathe. It doesn't really matter that much which technique you use, but the more accurate you make your mold, the more accurate you output. Which is quite nice because if you put a lot of effort in your mold once, you can easily replicate more products. So prototype around with different kinds of molds, but make sure your final one is accurate and well made. So now we're going to test a few molds in the machines. First thing we do is going to select which type of plastic we're going to use. And personally, we like to use ABS, polypropylene and polyethylene, because we can easily find them around and they're pretty easy to mold into something new. So the first step is we're going to shred it. Here we have the injection machine, and for this machine we have several different molds. So for instance, we use this one. It's a CNC millet block aluminum, and this is nice. However, this is quite an expensive technique to use. So we also made one using the lathe. This is actually the technique we use to make the spinning toy mold, and this is quite easy to do and affordable. Or you make them from some steel and weld it all together. So let's try this one out. We're gonna make a handle. Plastics. You can tell when it's done when you can't press anymore. Then it should be good. So now we use the red and the white mixture of different colors, but as you can imagine, using different colors or separating them, you can also make them solid black or blue or create this marble-like textures. In the extrusion machine, you can throw a lot of mixed colors, and the nice thing is that it turns around and it blends everything together, so you get one nice solid color coming out. For instance, here we started off with blue and white and slowly added more red, so you can create nice gradients. And you can use it to create new raw material. You could chop it and turn it into new granulate. Use it to weave something new, like this hat. Or you can spin it around the tools to create handlebars. Or get really creative and put a mold under here where you can turn it around. I mean, with just a single line of plastic, you can do a whole lot. The compression machine basically compresses two plates together. Now, if you're gonna add some plastic in between, it squeezes it together, so we create this plastic sheets. And obviously, we can play around with colors and mix them and blend them together to create something spacey or not. But we can also get more three-dimensional, for instance, by adding a texture. But we can even make it more three-dimensional by making more three-dimensional molds. And this one is from this fruit bowl we make. And this way we can create these nice little bowls and containers. Another cool thing is that you can also make more solid objects. And it's super strong. Now in itself, this isn't really useful. But if you look at this like wood and use conventional tooling, you can create a lot of new things with it.
Sorry, the bowl one.
Obviously, there's much more possible with these machines, and we barely made a few examples. So we would love to see what you can come up with. So if you made something, please share it. And if you have any questions, feel free to post the topic in our forums. All right, so that's it for now. I wish you the very best of luck making things, and have fun recycling.